Hi everyone. In today's video, I will show you how to create picture reveal game. Picture reveal game is a popular game that consists of four puzzle pieces covering a complete picture. To get clues, players have to answer corresponding questions on the board correctly. If the answer is incorrect, no piece is revealed and the players are unable to answer the question again. Their job is to try to open the pieces to guess what the picture is, then type their answer into the answer box. Let's get started. The steps to create this game include creating puzzle slide, creating four question slides, customizing feedback layers, adding interactivity, and previewing and exporting game. We insert a fill-in text entry question and other objects into this slide. Then, drag them to suitable positions and style them. I make four puzzle pieces by using copy and paste commands. Now let's customize the main puzzle question. We can easily change its font size, color, and format. There are four pieces of puzzle equivalent to four questions in this game, so we need to add four slides. To save time, we use Slide Master to create a question layout for all of these four questions. In this question layout, I first add a background image, then I resize and reposition the question area, and style to blend them with the background image. After that, I close the Slide Master view. In normal view, I use the question layout which has just been modified to add new questions. Here you can add one type of question as you want. For example, I add a multiple choice question. You can perform the same steps to create the other question slides. Let's move on to the next part, customizing feedback layers. You can open the Feedback Master view through the View tab. To illustrate a correct answer, I will add a picture to the correct feedback layer. Then, I move the picture to the bottom layer by pressing Ctrl End. After that, I drag the message to another position for being seen easily. Then change the color, style, and so on. After the player clicks this continue button, it will navigate to the first slide. Therefore, we need to add a go to slide 1 action to this button. We do the same to the continue button of the incorrect feedback layer. Each correct answer needs a different picture. So we make 3 other states for this image. I name each state after the correct answer to each question. And rename the normal state too. Return to the normal view. Here we come to the most important part of making this game, adding interactivity. First, we insert a shape to show the instructions. To create a voice for the instructions, we use the text-to-speech feature. There is a hidden image. To get clues, you have to answer some questions on the left. Try to guess what the image is. After that, type your answer into the answer box and press Enter, or click Submit to submit your answer. So as not to start this voice automatically, I need to hide it by right-clicking it and choosing Initially Hidden. Now I add actions to show the detailed instructions and start playing the voice if the player clicks the board. As the duration of the voice is about 14 seconds, I will hide it after it stopped playing. Next, we need to modify the answer section such as setting the correct value, and deselecting case sensitive, so that it will treat uppercase and lowercase letters equally. If the player answers correctly, I would like to play an audio voice and show stars. I will create these stars in an interactive timeline. First, you insert a star shape and change its color. Then, you create its motion path and add effects. For more information about how to use motion paths, please watch the video above. After that, you just need to apply the animation of this star to the others, and change the motion path direction if necessary. Let's preview this timeline one. We switch back to the main timeline and hide all the stars at first. Then, add actions to the onCorrect event of the answer box. We continue adding interactivity to these four puzzle pieces. To easily add action to them, we need to rename them first. One-click puzzle piece navigates to a different question slide. Therefore, we add the Go to Slide action to each puzzle piece. To get a quicker result, you can copy and paste this event to the other puzzle pieces. The logic is that after the player answered a question and came back to the first slide, the puzzle piece is either revealed or changed to the disabled state. So, I will create a disabled state for each piece. I would like to add a sad icon to this state, so I first add it to the resources pane. The sad icon is now added to the resources pane. We add a disabled state for this puzzle piece. Then, import this sad icon from resources to the disabled state and change the background color. We apply the same steps to the other puzzle pieces. Now we need to create advanced actions to link four pieces, answers to four questions, and correct feedback layers with each other. First, we add variables for four puzzle pieces and four correct feedback layers. We use text variables for puzzle pieces because we don't need to set default values. After that, we can set the value for a correct answer to true or false in the onCorrect event of each question. We use true/false variables for feedback because feedback has only two possible values, and we can set its default values to true or false. We add the first advanced action and name it flip to flip the puzzle pieces. Two possible cases are hiding the puzzle piece if the answer is correct, and changing the puzzle piece state to disabled if the answer is incorrect. The second advanced action is for the onCorrect event. We name it onCorrect. Here we need to add a string parameter named correct, and four Boolean parameters representing four feedback images. We add actions to show feedback image of a correct answer. And set the correct variable to true. So, now when you return to the first slide, the variable value in the flip action is set to true and the puzzle piece, therefore, is hidden. Besides, we should also pay attention to the order of the actions. The third advanced action is for the onIncorrect event. We name it onIncorrect. As I don't use feedback image in the incorrect feedback layer, this action is quite simple. It just has actions to change feedback layers and set the variable to false. So, we have created all the advanced actions. Now we just need to assign them to the suitable events. Let's begin with the onCorrect and onIncorrect events of each question. We do the same to the other question slides. Next, we add the flip advanced actions to the onLoad event of slide 1. Finally, we add the change object state action to the onLoad event of the correct feedback layer. So, that's all about how to create picture reveal game with ActivePresenter 8. Let's see the preview now. There is a hidden image. To get clues, you have to answer some questions on the left. Try to guess what the image is. After that, type your answer into the answer box and press enter, or click submit to submit your answer. Thank you for watching. See you in the next videos.